Hello everyone. Now we will be discussing about the lab 3 program that is again divided into two subdivisions 3A and 3B. So we will be discussing about the 3A program first. Write a Java program to read two integers A and B, compute A by B and print when B is not 0. Raise an exception when B is equal to 0. What you have to do is we have simple operation we have to do. We have to take two integers from A and B from the user. Then we have to calculate A by B and print when B is not 0. So if B is 0, then means you will get an exception like division by 0, because division by 0 is undefined. So you have to raise an exception like this. So in this you can see division is a class I'm creating here, and it's a main function. It is having the main function. The class name should be then division. Okay, so it is taking the two integers from the user. And for raising an exception, you have to use the try catch block. That is, in the try, I have to write the result. What should be the result? Result is equal to A by B, and it will print. If it is throwing some exception, that will be received by the catch function here. That will be an arithmetic exception E. And it should print that exception got division by zero error. So that will be the arithmetic exception which will be thrown by A by B. It's a simple program. So we will check how we will be getting the output for this. So I'm creating a new class that is division, because division is a class which contains a main function. Then I have already copied it. I'm keeping it here. Now there is an error in this. We will see what is the error. This is the closing of the main function. I have to close one more bracket here. Okay. Now system.out.println. Okay, that's it. Okay, now I have to print it. Sorry, I have to run it. Input two integers. See, I'm giving the integers 6 and 2. You got the result as 3. You are able to see this one, right? Okay, I'll 6 by 2 result is equal to 3. And if I run it once again, I'll give another input. It is 6 and 0. Can you see this one? Say exception got division by 0. So division by 0 is an exception which is called because I give B as 0. So this is the way you have to do this. Now we will discuss the next program, that is 3B program. Write a Java program that implements a multi-thread of application that has 3 threads. First thread generates a random integer for every 1 second. Second thread computes the square of the number and prints. And third thread will print the value of cube of the number. Now what do you do? You have to implement a multi-thread application. First thread generates a random integer for every 1 second. That means every 1 second it will generate a random integer. Second thread computes the square of the number and print. Then third thread will print the value of the cube of the number. So if a print a number is taken, it should print the square and cube. Now we will see from the main function we will check so that we will understand better. So this is another class. So it has two classes. One is class second, and the other one is public class multi-thread. So here multi-thread will be the program name because it contains the main function. So what I'm doing is I'm creating an object of the class first. So can you see what the first is? The first is here. This is another class first. So class second, class third, class first, and multi-thread. So there are 4 classes in this. Now class first extends thread. That means it was a multi, since we are using multi-thread, there is an inbuilt class called thread that we are extending it here. After that, see what you are doing here, a dot start. So whenever you are doing a multi-threading program, when you call the start function, it's an inbuilt function and the thread class which will automatically run the run function. So here the run function is this. What it will do is it will take a random number. So random is an inbuilt class, in that we are creating an object for this. What we do, we are doing here, we are taking num is equal to r dot extend system.out.println. First thread generated number is num. So we are taking the input from the user, we are printing it. And what you are doing is we are creating the object for the second class. That means second. Now we will see what is second. Second also is what it implements run number, because it is extending the class. And it is the run function is what second thread square of the number is x into x. It is printing it. So whichever values it got through this. It is assigning the value here in the x. And do you know why we are using this dot x? Because if we want to copy one variable to another variable, this represents the current class. That means we are copying here. Here is x and here is x. So if I write x is equal to x, means compiler will give an error, because x as compiler will not be able to understand which x. So this dot x means the current class x. That means this public int x is equal to this x, so that it will be assigned to here. Now same, the third class, we are doing the same process and we are printing the cube here. So we will run this, and after this one, thread.sleep, then the thread will go to the, this one is millisecond, so it will go to 1 second. Now this is the exception also is there. If it is throwing an exception, we have to caught it. Now we will run the program. So I have already typed the program here. So the class name will be what? Multithread. Again, create new class multithread. It should be the same class name, and it is case sensitive also. Now one more error is there here, because when I copy it, okay. Then one more error here, because the remaining came in the next line. Now I'll run it. See, the first thread generated number is 82, and 82, what is the square of the number? You can see the square of the number as this. What is the cube of the number? This is the cube of the number. The second generated number is 23. That is, it is random generation. It is generating the number randomly. So after 88, it is printing 23, which in the square of the number is this, and the cube of the number is this. Third generated number is 46. This is the square of the number, and this is a cube. This is a cube of that number. So this is the way you have to do this. Hope you understood this video, and this is a way we have to do here. So here in this third A and third B, you are doing two things. One is third A, you are studying about the exception, and third B program, we are studying about multi-threading. So as you know, thread is a part of process which can run independently. So this these are the threads which is created by the computer, and we won't be knowing how many threads will be created. It will be totally assigned by the OS. So whenever it, and here we are using the concept of random number also. We have used a class also, random class, which is used to generate random numbers. So here, after you can see, after 23, 46, 36, 99, it is creating random numbers. So this is the way you have to implement this one. I hope you understood these two programs. And there is a chance that you will do more syntactical mistakes when you write this program, because this dot x is equal to x, and you have to write it correctly. And you are using here so many classes also. There is a chance that you will be missing the brackets also. So try to do the program execution by yourself. That's all for today. Thank you so much.